If you get engaged in sins after Ramadan, your deeds could be in vain. All what you have done in Ramadan in vain. All what you have done in Ramadan in vain. We know that sometimes you could do deeds and you had everything right, but after you did it, it's in vain. Example. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم. O ye who believe, do not raise your voices loud above the voice of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. What that means? What would happen if you do this? Your deeds will become what? In vain. Will become fruitless. In the day of resurrection, you will come, you will find no deeds in your books. You know this verse was revealed in who? Anybody knows? In who? Al-Khayran. Hadith Ibn Abi Mulaika fi Muslim. كاد الخيران أن يهلكا. Who's Al-Khayran? Abu Bakr wa Umar. They had some argument and their voices went up. So the deeds of Abu Bakr and Umar, they are good deeds, hasanat. But now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, if you raise your voices like this, all your deeds will be what? In vain. So it is possible that you could end up doing good deeds and then after that, it's gone. It's not there anymore. Another example. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى. O ye believe, do not invalidate your sadaqat by doing man. Oh, I given something to Allah. Adha, or I given you money. This does not talk about you not having the right intention when you're given the money. No. This is actually after you're given the sadaqah and you had the right intention. And you did it for the sake of Allah. But because of the man and the harm that you did to the person that you're given the sadaqah to, your deeds are invalid. The same exact thing, all your qiyam, all your siyam in Ramadan, all your acts of obedience could turn to be in vain or fruitless. What is the evidence? Hadith Thawban. Well, hadith fi Sunan Ibn Majah. And I know this hadith scares everyone, including me. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَأَعْلَمَنَّ أَقْوَامًا مِنْ أُمَّتِي يَأْتُونَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِحَسَنَاتٍ أَمْثَالِ جِبَالِ تِهَامَةَ بَيْضًا فَيَجْعَلُهَا اللَّهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. I know some of my followers who will come in the day of resurrection with hasanat. Hasanat means what? Good what? A lot of it. The size of what? A terrain of mountain called Tiham. Bayda, it's in reference to intention, sincerity, purity. But Allah will turn it into scatter dust. Sifhum lana ya Rasulallah. Describe them for us, O Messenger of Allah. Shuf. Min jildati. They are like us. They speak like us. That means what? They have the proper creed, the proper deen. Not only this, وَيَأْخُذُونَ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا تَأْخُذُونَ. They break tahajjud at night. They break tahajjud at night. وَيَأْخُذُونَ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا تَأْخُذُونَ. But here is what they do. وَلَكِنَّهُمْ إِذَا خَلَوْا بِمَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ إِنْتَهَكُوهَا. When they feel that they are by themselves, somewhere, they what? They commit the sin. They commit the sin. إذا ما خلوت الدهر يوما فلا تقل خلوت ولكن قل علي رقيب ولا تحسبن الله يغفل ساعة وأن ما تخفيه عنه يغيب. ألم تر أن الله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض
ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثة إلا هو رابعهم ولا خمسة إلا هو سادسهم ولا أدنى من ذلك ولا أكثر إلا هو معهم أينما كانوا.
Those people, once they see themselves by themselves, they commit the sin. They commit the sin. And يعني, just for you to get a peace of mind regarding this issue, and I have researched a little bit regarding this hadith, it really indicates that if you do the sin in private, one day you will do it in public. A sin, by the way, that you're keen on doing it in private between you and yourself, because of the fact that you're doing it all the time, behind closed doors and windows, one day you will do it outside. Because you're not going to see it as sin anymore. You're not. The heart will become corrupt. The heart will not see it as sin anymore. Will not. Because you're used to it. And you're going to end up committing it in front of everybody. And the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said about this, كل أمتي معافى كما عند البخاري كل أمتي معافى إلا المجاهرين. All my ummah will be pardoned except those who commit sins openly. They will not have a chance to repent. This is the issue once it comes to the consequences of basically having that disease or sickness, which is degradation, basically, or not doing as you used to do in Ramadan. طيب, very quickly, what are the reasons behind this disease? Why? Why do you have this disease? Number one, ضعف الإيمان. ضعف الإيمان. What is the definition of الإيمان? الإيمان, heart, tongue, actions. In your heart, you believe in Allah. You declare it with your tongue. You say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. That's why we say it's a shahada. And then you implement this with the tongue, with the rest of the limbs. Here is the piece that we're not aware of. الإيمان يزيد وينقص. It increases and it what? Decreases. إنهم فتية آمنوا بربهم وزدناهم هدى. They are youth who believed in Allah and we increased them in guidance. والذين اهتدوا زادهم هدى وآتاهم تقواهم. So iman increases and decreases. And this is a statement that was made by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. He said, I have met 1,000 of the scholars of this ummah, and all of them defined faith, iman, to be heart, tongue, limbs, and it increases and decreases. Now, what makes your iman increases? Ta'a. You're sitting here tonight, this will kick your iman up. If you're sitting right in front of the television right now, at the same time, your iman will go what? Down. You open the Quran and recite one page, your iman what? Goes up. هكذا. Up and down. Up and down. You pray tahajjud. Up. And here's the issue. When your iman goes down, that's when it's dangerous. What causes your iman to go down? Abandoning the acts of worship and engaging in sins. The iman what? Drops. When your iman drops, all these acts that you used to do in Ramadan, which made your iman move up, now you left it and you got engaged in disobedience, you become a victim to your enemies. Who are your enemies? An-nafs wa-shaytan and the human enemy. نفسك You're sitting right. You know, if your iman is down, your nafs is going to come after you. Let's go and have some fun. Come on, you fasted Ramadan. Let's go and... طب, what about the 6th of Shawwal? Later, later. Still have time. Shaitan comes to you. A bad friend calls you. وهكذا. You become a... Then you lose that immunity. You see, iman, ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لك لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو. انت فاهم هذا الكلام ولا مش فاهم؟ A person will not commit adultery when he's a believer. Because al-iman gives what? Immunity. He's a Muslim soul. ما هو اصل الايمان اللي هو الايه؟ الاسلام. He's a Muslim. But he's not a believer. Because if he's a believer, he should have that immunity. Immunity from what? From adultery. ولا يسرق. He does not steal when he's a believer. So when your iman is weakened, you're exposed more. You know, your heart is the limb that contains that iman. القلب مستودع الإيمان ومستودع الإخلاص. القلب. You know, imagine your heart. When you do a lot of acts of worship, you're guarding this heart. When you abandon these acts of worship, your enemies will start shooting what? Arrows. Imagine this. Wallah, this is how it's done. The shaitan will what? Subhanallah, Allah guarded this heart with what? With the chest. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس وير في قلوب ولا في صدور قلوب الناس. But really شيطان wants what? He wants what? He wants the heart. But the heart is protected by the chest. So he does the waswasa in the outside. If the heart does not have iman, the waswasa is going to do what? Penetrate. It's like throwing an arrow, and then the iman gives a shield. هذا يعني فهم ابن القيم. This is not my talk. I know for you this is all sci-fi, but this is how he actually explained it. That imagine your heart traveling, because you're traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that limb, with the heart. In order for this limb to travel, imagine you see, in أعلم هكذا قوله أعلم حفظك الله أن الإنسان مسافر إلى ربه. That you are in a state of constant travel to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وأنك تقطع المسافة بقلبك. And you travel, the limb that he used to travel is your heart. Imagine your heart is what? Is the car that you're going to Allah with. You're traveling to Allah with. Now, the car needs what to run? The car needs what? Fuel. If you don't have the fuel for the heart, for the car, what is going to happen? The car is going to start what? Then the road, the people, what do you call those people in the road who come and take away your stuff? What do you call this? Huh? What tow trucks? Hijackers. The road hijackers. No, that like the people who come and yeah, they steal your stuff because your car is kaput. The same exact thing. When your heart is fueled with iman, with ta'ah, then it's what? Flying to Allah. Flying to Allah. But when it does not have it, then what? They start what? Let's get that heart. Shoot. Arrows, until they bring you down. هكذا. فضعف الإيمان مشكلة. Is a problem. ضعف الإيمان. And inshallah, one of these days, I will give us a topic about ضعف الإيمان and how can you... Because it's a problem.